I suddenly realized, well, you know, I have a certain amount of money. I don't have kids. I live reasonably modestly for, you know, compared to what I could do. This jewelry is some of my vices, but, you know, it's not tens of thousands of dollars. So I ended up with a small fortune without actually realizing it until I added up everything. So then I started thinking, you know, what can I do? And what can I do to help that the sort of science, the sort of solid state science, the sort of thermodynamics we do, et cetera, will continue for many, many years beyond my lifetime. So then it essentially made sense to make a major gift to ASU. I'm a chemist by training. Went to the Bronx High School of Science, got a lot of AP credit, then went to the University of Chicago and went from freshman year to PhD in 7 years. Did two postdoctoral appointments, one in Germany, one at Penn State, and then my first faculty position was here at ASU in 1969. What my interests are is basically in understanding how and why materials are stable. In a practical sense, if you're going to use something, you know, be it a microwave oven or a cell phone or something like that, it's made of a whole variety of different materials, and they have to last a reasonably long time, and they have to not react with each other, and they have to be mechanically and chemically stable. When I left ASU in 1985, Princeton University recruited me. It was rather amusing because during the time I was a grad student, et cetera, Princeton wasn't even co-ed at that time. None of the Ivies were. They all sort of finally admitted women somewhere around the early 70s for the most part. And then, you know, 15 years later, they were all recruiting me like mad. And I got a very good offer and I decided, you know, I've got to try being a Princeton professor. But I kept a lot of ties with ASU, with my colleagues and friends here. So in some sense, this was still home. The question then really came up was, you know, should I come back to ASU? At my age, do I have the energy to do something new? And basically, we set up the Center for Materials of the Universe that essentially embodies these ideas. They gave me the labs here and helped, you know, eventually build them. And I am now, you know, very happy to essentially be back effectively at what was my starting point in my home. And I've, you know, seen what's been happening at ASU. So in a sense, you know, in a sense, I've always had that loyalty. ASU has a long and distinguished tradition in solid state science. The new opportunities in materials of the universe related then to solid state science are something that I hope will continue at ASU for many years, and my endowment should help stabilize and energize that effort. I think we've done very well, we're happy, and I'm convinced now after being here since October of 2019 that I made the right choice to come back home. And, you know, I hope that I have a number of good years to continue doing things, having fun, and helping ASU.